Hey, good afternoon. It's February 18th, 2024, and we are in the Old Testament book of 2 Chronicles, and we're going to read chapter 22. Our chronicler is going to give us the story of Ahaziah. Let's see, he's the grandson of Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat was a mostly good king, tried to do some reforms. They didn't quite stick. Jehoshaphat's big sin was he kept wanting to be friends and buddy-buddy with Ahab, king of Israel, who was evil. Then he had a son. His son went married into the family of Ahab. So even more evil and less reforms. Not any reforms, really. And his son just chases after Ahab. He only reigns 1 year. In fact, his chasing after Ahab's descendant, Joram, is what does him in, because he goes to visit him when Jehu has been sent to wipe out Israel's king so they can start over. And he is killed as well, and his mother takes over. So now we have Ahab's evil daughter in charge of Judah. And she does not do very well, and she doesn't last very long either. But we can see there our descent of Judah is getting pretty close to rock bottom. It'll come back a little bit, but it never goes up as high as it went down until we end up with the exile. So let's go ahead and we're going to read 2 Chronicles chapter 22. Then the inhabitants of Jerusalem made Ahaziah, his youngest son, king in his place, for the raiders who came with the Arabians into the camp had killed all the older sons. So Ahaziah, the son of Jehoram, king of Judah, reigned. Ahaziah was 42 years old when he became king, and he reigned 1 year in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Athaliah, the granddaughter of Omri. He also walked in the ways of the house of Ahab, for his mother advised him to do wickedly. Therefore he did evil in the sight of the Lord, like the house of Ahab, for they were his counselors after the death of his father to his destruction. He also followed their advice and went with Jehoram, the son of Ahab, king of Israel, to war against Hazael, king of Syria, at Ramoth-Gilead, and the Syrians wounded Joram. Then he returned to Jezreel to recover from the wounds which he had received at Ramoth, when he fought against Hazael, king of Syria. And Azariah, the son of Jehoram, king of Judah, went down to see Jehoram, the son of Ahab, in Jezreel, because he was sick. His going to Joram was God's occasion for Ahaziah's downfall, for when he arrived, he went out with Jehoram against Jehu, the son of Nimshi, whom the Lord had anointed to cut off the house of Ahab. And it happened when Jehu was executing judgment on the house of Ahab and found the princes of Judah and the sons of Ahaziah's brothers who served Ahaziah that he killed them. Then he searched for Ahaziah, and they caught him. He was hiding in Samaria, and brought him to Jehu. When they had killed him, they buried him, because they said he is the son of Jehoshaphat, who sought the Lord with all his heart. So the house of Ahaziah had no one to assume power over the kingdom. Now when Athaliah, the mother of Uzziah, saw that her son was dead, she arose and destroyed all the royal heirs of the house of Judah. But Jehoshabeath, the daughter of the king, took Joash, the son of Ahaziah, and stole him away from among the king's sons who were being murdered, and put him in his nurse in a bedroom. So Jehoshabeath, the daughter of King Jehoram, the wife of Jehoiada, the priest, for she was the sister of Ahaziah, hid him from Athaliah so that she did not kill him. And he was hidden with them in the house of God for 6 years, while Athaliah reigned over the land. May God bless the reading of his word. May God bless you. Bye.